Welcome, Tom Leine from Finland, so over here in Copenhagen at the European Crowdsourcing Week. You just shared your story today. What did you share with the audience?
Well, we talk about a paradigm shift in using crowds for developing public services. That was one of the things. But basically, we talked about mostly on one specific case, about the Queen Silvia Nursing Award in Sweden, where we were helping develop the national healthcare and dementia care services for elderly.
And how did you do it?
It was a very interesting project. It went really well. We engaged the nursing students in Sweden to come up with new sorts of ideas. And then, of course, as a crowdsourcing platform, we used the same people to peer evaluate each other's ideas and trying to understand the novelty about the business potential, about the size of the problem that these ideas were solving and so forth. And then eventually, yes, there was a huge amount of ideas, over 330 ideas that came out of 140 students.
Interesting.
And over 3,000 peer evaluation tasks performed, over 800 comments given to each other's ideas, and generally comments that helped further develop these ideas. And that was brilliant.
Interesting.
So really a joint effort.
And your company, what's doing your company?
Our company is called InOpinion. We are a, I don't want to call it a crowdsourcing platform, but an engagement platform, because it really helps engaging different types of shareholder groups or stakeholders to various types of cases. We basically productized three types of services on top of platform. One is for employee engagement, for internal processes, like internal innovation or strategy work or testing certain types of for example, sales and marketing plans. Second one is for customer engagement, for customer loyalty, customer awareness, new customer acquisition and so forth. And the third one is really for idea competitions and challenges.
Sorry, the last one was?
For idea competitions and challenges. So generally any type of open innovation competitions, for example. And at the moment, we have running a competition called sumpitching.com. And it's an open online business idea competition for anyone to join for free. And leveraging crowdsourcing to evaluate the ideas and get feedback and build market report on what your idea is all about. Is it any good or not?
Yeah, and what is your magic formula for getting people engaged in a platform or a competition?
That's a magic formula. Yeah, it sometimes feels like magic. It does really. We have different types of gamification in the play. So we have different types of very traditional gamification methods like credits, points, levels, stages, badges, and so forth, leaderboards. But we also do have other activation methods. So we instead of waiting for people to come over, we actually do use different media to engage them. We send them email activation messages. They can go online, and we're building mobile applications to engage with people and so forth. So the participants can actually choose which medium they want to use to participate. And gamification, of course, is an interesting method to activate people, but the virtual goods are only good to a certain point. So in basically all of our campaigns, we also provide real-life benefits like access codes to certain free services or vouchers, gift cards, mobile phones, movie tickets, different types of activation methods.
And today we also had the launch of Mobber.com. Did you also watch their presentation?
Yeah. Actually, I was actually just going through their website just recently. So interesting opportunity there. There's quite a few crowdsourcing platforms there. We are basically trying to differentiate ourselves in the method that we're engaging people and showing the activity levels that we can reach. And those have, so far at least, they've been quite significant. So.
Yeah, interesting. So because I was thinking when I was hearing a story, maybe it's nice to add their tool to your website, so people can also make money by participating
Exactly. We don't offer money as such, but prices, definitely prices, and those are good motivation. If it would be just money, I think it would. It would activate, of course, a certain types of people, but some people would be devastated that their social innovation would be somehow measured in money. Yep. And especially for the campaigns that we run for public offices and ministries and NGOs, I don't think we could ever offer money as a prize.
Yeah.
So I think it would just create a lot of fuss about, you know, wrong things in the campaign.
Okay, and what are the marks? Because you today you was at a conference. Did you get some new ideas about
operations? We did plenty.
Can you share some?
No, unfortunately not. But we are actually still going to be talking later today about with a couple of organizations about how to collaborate. But definitely we're especially interested in talking to crowdfunding platforms, because we feel that the method that we have could well be used in crowdfunding as well. So in crowdfunding campaigns, instead of just losing a lot of people not, you know, coming to the website, perhaps even signing up to updates or giving thumbs up to an idea, and they don't necessarily invest at all. So we want to help understand why people don't invest, or why they are investing, or what are the points that a company should be pitching better that would help, you know, create better awareness or understanding of the business potential. So I think there's a number of different crowdsourcing platforms that we could collaborate easily and would like to collaborate. So we're open for business. So
of course,
come and knock on our door.
So then you're offering also a tool to better understand their crowds.
Definitely. That's one of the main points. It's not just about content, but understanding the community. That's one reason why we're calling it an engagement platform, because we want to help understand why the community is doing what they're doing, who they are, what they're interested in or good at. And generally that's a market research report kind of stuff.
And do you also, because there was also a nice talk today about disrupting the government.
Yeah. We love that subject as such. Yeah.
I think that's for you also a big chance.
Yeah, of course. But we've seen that already in a number of countries. We have plans in Indonesia to help the newly elected president to understand the problems that lie in the country. We want to, of course, give some positive pressure from the public, for public authorities in different countries to really do what they promise to do, or solve the most important problems, not just problems that they think are you know, nicest or easiest to solve, but problems that are the toughest or most important.
Positive pressure, interesting.
We like to think of ourselves as a social influencer as well. And we've actually, one thing that I didn't mention today here is that actually 10% of all the business that we do goes for NGOs and charities. So each year we will be picking 5 to 10 charity cases that we do absolutely for free. And then we try to pick something that's really building the social innovation and you know, helping people around the world to solve the main problems.
Okay, interesting. And what do you think has to change? Because we're also looking at, what barriers do we have to remove to make this collaborative economy as successful long term? What do you think are the biggest challenges?
Oh, there's plenty. I could name a
top three.
A lot. Top three. That's a good one. I think in general we are focusing on developing countries. So there's a lot of issues about sanity and clean water, electricity, democracy even. So these are the obstacles that we want to help solving. You know, whether it's about poverty or you know, clean tech related issues or ideas that we're hoping to collect, we don't mind. We just actually the 5 to 10 cases that we hope to be picking every year, we try to find very very different cases. It's of course a good test for our platform as well to see how far can we go and what we can do. But in general, doing good and giving back to the community is one of the core ideas. How we feel.
Okay.
We're actually born out of an NGO originally as a product idea. So we feel that giving back is really important.
So and your next steps are maybe into the crowdfunding scenes, as you mentioned?
Let's see, working with Microsoft IPO, no, not really. we are generally we're still building and further developing the platform as such. But one of the most important things is that we just basically want to try the different services that we productized, and we want to build a repeatable business on top of our platform. Yeah. Now we've been doing 30 plus cases all over the world, but we want to really see the repeat business much more.
Yeah.
We want to standardize the platform, but we're still in the development phases.
Okay, interesting. Say good luck, enjoy.
Thank you.